today we are doing a comparison video for HubSpot versus Copper. Now, we have quite a few different comparison articles comparing Airtable as a CRM versus Copper, Salesforce as a CRM versus Copper, I think Streak versus Copper. So we had a request to do one versus HubSpot. So here we are. My first question is, what's appealing about HubSpot?
So HubSpot's done a really good job at they have a really solid marketing suite that has a lot of like marketing automation at scale, and they realize that the best way to sell these really expensive services are have some like free versions of things. So they've created a free CRM. So most people have probably heard about HubSpot because they're like, oh, it's a free CRM and I'm a small business or I'm a startup. Like, I don't want to, you know, pay for something that I don't know if I quite need yet. Or even a bit more, you might be a startup and using HubSpot because they gave you the first year free. It's one of those things that it's like, okay, this sounds like such a no-brainer. But the problem is it very quickly starts getting expensive because you're paying essentially for number of contacts. So think of every person that maybe signs up for your service or any lead that comes in or any kind of, you have a cold email list of, you know, 5,000 people that you're going to be sending an email to. All that starts adding up quite quickly, and then paying per contact in the CRM essentially per month and per year, you very quickly could go from a free tool to spending anywhere from 10 to 40, 50, 60 plus $1,000 a year. So that is like the top level of what you'd be paying for any of these other CRMs. Like, probably be hard pressed to even spend that kind of money with a tool like Copper. So I think people essentially go into HubSpot because they think it's free and they hear, oh, it integrates with everything. But most of the integrations, they've actually moved to their own walled garden of use our integration with our marketing suite. But there are other tools, for example, marketing tools that you can integrate, say Pipedrive and Copper with, that are cheaper because they're not really geared toward the enterprise side of things. Whereas HubSpot is really trying to go after Salesforce. So they are trying to build tools that are more enterprise tools so that people maybe switch from Salesforce to HubSpot or get on HubSpot before they even think about going to Salesforce. HubSpot does have somewhat of an out of control API because it does so many things that it's actually really difficult to work with. If the tool claims to do everything, the tool will often claim to do things, and then, like, let's say the tool says, okay, I integrate with QuickBooks Online. And you're like, well, I use QuickBooks, so yeah, this is a no-brainer. So you set it up, and then what you realize is all that it actually does is, like, you can view your QuickBooks invoices from your CRM, but what you had thought that it would do would be, like, moving to a stage and have that automatically generate an invoice and send that to the customer. One equates to time savings in terms of actually replacing time that work that you would have otherwise done. And the other one is just kind of like a nice to have, like, oh, I have a better 360-degree view. So there's a lot of these quote-unquote integrations that marketing people at these companies, they just want to check that box and say, cool, we integrate with XYZ tool, but it doesn't really get across what the integration is. So when working with someone like us, it's actually more speaking to, well, what do you wish this tool was able to do? Or what is someone on your team doing over and over and over in this tool? And then can we reverse engineer that and say, oh, cool, well, what if from the CRM, we just triggered this invoice to automatically be generated when you move a stage or this document to send out to a customer or a document to be completed in a different tool and have that create a deal or an opportunity in your current CRM. So there's just more thought around, I guess, the process of what the integration can do and less about actually, great, it integrates, because that means so many different things to so many different people.
So yeah, just to summarize, two red flags that have come up already is if you're considering HubSpot and you have a lot of contacts that you're potentially going to be putting into the CRM, red flag. If you're free for the first year, you're probably not going to be, and you are going to continuously hike that HubSpot mountain of price. And the second piece is if you're considering HubSpot because of the appealing integrations, always take a look at what does that integration mean.
Yeah, it's an easy thing to come back to. The reason that I selected Copper in the first place is still the reason why I recommend it today. They integrate so deeply with Google Workspace. So if you're using Google Workspace, it's something to highly consider. If you're not using Google Workspace, I will actually say stay clear of it. They're really not trying to build anything with Office 365 or anything of the sort. But they're investing a lot of resources into integrations between their tool and Google Workspace. So for example, when you add someone to the CRM and you add their email address in there, it will actually go through everyone on your entire team that's within Copper, the last year of their email history, and retroactively sync all of those emails into the CRM. When you're sending emails that have like file attachments, Copper will also take all those files and organize them really nicely in the CRM under the person record, even the company record. So say that you do a lot of business with a company, every file attachment that you ever send to any person within that company will kind of just be like organized within the CRM. So you can tell your teammate like, oh, you know, I sent that to Jim at ABC Corp the other day. If you want to go find it, they could literally go to the CRM, click in Jim ABC Corp, and they could just find that file right there. So there's just more of a collaboration component to it all. And there really hasn't been any CRM in the market that's focused on that type of thing, because I know it is quite expensive to do that server bandwidth wise. So even though a company like Pipedrive can maybe invest in the resources to do that, it just doesn't make sense for them to do that because their costs would go up quite substantially. And I think it really only makes sense to focus on that if that's the core customer that you're focusing on and that's their business model. So if you fit into their business model, you're just going to get a better user experience with that. Yeah, there's no benefit for like if you sign up for Copper on your own or if you were already using Copper or anything in between, that doesn't matter to us. It's just a great foundation that we recommend using. And that's kind of the reason why we even talk about Copper.
Yeah, I think with all the tools, like one, you know, most of you probably don't know Alex personally, but one of his passions is really just playing with software, and he's always doing that consistently. And I think we're lucky because we really do get to work with the best software on the market for our business needs, and all the software that we recommend, we use in our business as well. With that, I think it just comes back to like we keep recommending Copper because we generally think it's the best CRM. I think this wraps up this conversation. Like Alex's shirt says, we're here to help. So if you have any questions, just reach out, leave a comment, write us an email. If you are interested in getting our help with your CRM implementation or processes or integrating two pieces of software, and yes, that can be HubSpot as well, then reach out to us. We also do have a complimentary audit, an operations audit for the right people. We have an application to apply for that down below. And that's a wrap. Thanks so much for being here.